As the afternoon goes on and the day gets much cooler, you will not be able to find a seat in here. But as of right now, if you come on down this time, you'll be sure to find a seat anywhere you want to. Lower seating, upper seating, there's seating all over the place. But nevertheless, come on down to the National Stadium and show support for our young athletes. Come show support for our primary school athletes. We have about, 19 schools? 17 schools, 575 athletes out here giving it their best for their school. And trust me, they are putting on a show. But everyone is patiently in the stands awaiting the 150 meters. They have not come out, the athletes have not come out as yet. But the lane assignments are there. We are just waiting for the athletes and the officials to give us the okay. But it looks like the first set of athletes, they are now heading towards their lane assignments. So this is going to be our first 150 meter dash for the day. Here they come. And I'm sure they are ready to go out there and compete and give it their best. I'm not sure if it's boys or girls. It looks to be girls. Looks to be girls coming out here. So the athlete is escorting them onto the track and in their respective lanes. Here they come. We do apologize for the camera footage, as we had some technical difficulties this morning. But nevertheless, the crew is doing their best to get all the cameras from every angle possible for all those who are watching via live footage. Okay, we still got long jump going on. I see E.L. Simons on one side, and on the other side is Iris Stubbs. So that one side is green and gray. That's the western pit, and on the eastern pit is green and white. I don't know who the DJ is, but the DJ is playing some Michael Jackson right about now, and I can see the officials on the track getting down, enjoying some Michael Jackson out here. Trust me. I'm sure with all that heat going on, they got to do something to get loose out there on the track.
Watch. Okay, event number nine and under girls, 150 meters. Heat one of three preliminaries. In lane one, Shawn Monica Williams, number 1, 2, 3 from the Doris Robinson primary. Siskashia Ann Etienne, number 272 running in lane two, it from the Iron Creek primary. In lane three, Sarah Rose, number 403 in lane four, Vianna Manassi, number 19 from the Adelaide Ungler primary. In lane five, Gianna Wilson, number 367 from the Ona Glinton primary. In lane six, Naomi Malcolm, number 178 from the Eliza Simons primary. In lane seven, Sojourney Taylor, number 321 from the Iris Stubbs primary. And in lane eight, Bianca Otten, number 226 from the Enid Capron primary. The nine and under girls, 150 meters, heat one of three preliminaries, event number nine.
Thank you.
Canberra. We are going to see who is going to win this one. Asika Johnny. Asika Johnny on the Clinton. And in Capron. That's the order. This is heat one of three for the 159 and under girls. This is event number nine. Coming up next, we're having the heat number two of three preliminaries. And the athletes are just about ready. All right, so we have some scores for you after day one. These are the points standing. 105 points is the Ona Glinton Primary School. So you're in first place. In second place so far is the Enid Capron Primary School, having 87 points. In third place, we have the Adelaide Ongler Primary School, having 59 points. In fourth place, Asita Jolly Primary, with 50 points. In place five, Eliza Simons Primary School.
Good morning, Turks and Caicos. You are now tuned into day two of the 2024 TCI Sports Commission partnering with TC3As. This is the 2024 Inter-Primary School Championships. Just to give you guys before we get into anything, after 45 events, I want to give you guys the point standings as we are at this moment. In 17th place, Mills Institute, 1 point. In 16th position, Bass Institute, 2 points. Doris Robinson Primary School, 15, with 3 points. Provo Middle School in the 14th position with 8 points. 13th position, Elite School with 9. Community Christian Academy, 12th place with 12 points. Provo Christian School in 11th place with 13 points. Then we have Thelma Lipin Primary School with 17 points in 10th position. In 9th position, Charles Hubert James Primary, 18 points. Iris Stubbs Primary School in 8th position with 23. In 7th place, INT Pratt Primary with 30 points. And 6th position, we have Richmond Hills Preparatory with 33 points. And 5th position, we have Eliza Simons Primary with 44. And in 4th place, Osita Jolly with 50 points. In 3rd place, Adelaide Amla Primary with 59. And in 2nd place, we have Enid Capron Primary with 87. And in first place, we have the Ona Glinton Primary School with 105 points. Yes, folks, this is through 45 events, not including anything here today. But, man, before we get into anything here, I have a guest with me. No stranger to you guys, no stranger to the soil. This is his bread and butter. Let him introduce himself.
Good morning, Turks and Caicos. My name is Angelo Garland, former national athlete of the Turks and Caicos Islands. Currently the head of sports performance here at TCI Sports Commission.
Well, Mr. Garland, this event for me has always been something that I take pride in, because this is our grassroots program. This is where we see our future athletes, I say, in terms of watching them go through the maturation process and understanding the juniors to the, you know, the primary, junior, and ascend to the senior levels. And every time we get out here, I always remember Rayvon Black from Ona Glinton, where, you know, he had a grand performance out here, and then he was able to be selected and go on to Jamaica for training, to further training and education. So,
in fact, just to stop it, pinpoint you right there, Raven Black just won his semifinal heat to make it to the finals of the Class 2 Boys Championship in Jamaica. He just ran about a few minutes ago, 50.76. He won his semifinal. So I think he's the second fastest going into the finals, which I think is tomorrow. Just minutes ago, just won his semifinal.
That's what I'm talking about.
So,
see, well, like I said again, that goes to show he was picked here because of his performance, and now he has the opportunity to further hone his skills. I mean, and you're no stranger to that because you came coming up to the same system, being able to get over to Jamaica and, you know, be able to better hone your skills. From your point of view, what you see here with our young kids, this is grassroots. So the mindset of some of our kids, they don't necessarily understand structure, especially yesterday, the 5-7. You would see them running, blow past the finish line and just into the track because their mind, I just want to run and play with my friends.
Right, right.
So for me, it's like now, this is now where you start to put in the structure so they understand what needs to be done. As we're watching now, the board jump with the boys under 9. So for me, it's like structure. You understand this is what it is and this is where we're trying to get to. So you put these things in place now that when they now get to that level, they have already have an understanding of it.
Right.
So you being in the position that you are, I know you do training with a lot of other athletes. What is some of the things that you do instill into these athletes getting ready for events such as this?
For the most part of it is discipline, you know, discipline, understanding, being accountable to know that, hey, you know, we're in the room, especially we do a lot of work in the gym, and sometimes it's myself, Coach Delano, Coach Tyler, that's a part of the sports performance team. We have Jada Baranco who also helps us from time to time, and sometimes it'd be like 20 to 30 athletes in the gym, and it's only 4 of us, and we have to tell them, like, hey, look, we have a board, we write the program down. Hey, just because we're not watching you when you're doing squats doesn't mean you shouldn't do it the right way. You know, so aspects of that, things where you can't necessarily learn in a classroom. That's kind of how we like to teach them. Like, you know, we were working with the Clem Ohio basketball team last week, and I said, you know, our job here isn't just to make you guys better athletes, but better individuals on the whole. You know, try to groom you from boys to men, you know. So certain things you have to take accountability for, certain things you have to take responsibility for, and you kind of have to learn how to take the initiative. That same thing we kind of do with the British Collegiate Softball team. You know, the national football team that we've been doing a lot of work with, maybe we try to instill those type of aspects in them.
Okay, well, that's definitely, I mean, again, you are transforming the whole child, not just a particular part, which goes hand in hand. But guys, just to give you an update on what's going on, this is now event 9. This is girls 8-9, 100-meter dash. This is heat 2 of 3. In lane 1, we have Christelle Cassette from Outlet Umlo. In lane 2, Kyrie Musgrove from Provo Middle, bit number 473. In lane 3, we have Asana Williams from Community Christian, bit number 111. In lane 4, we have Rebecca Hippolyte, bit number 503 from Richmond Hill. In lane 5, we have Lisa Pavulsa, bit number 549 from Thelma Lybron. In lane 6, we have Sammy Delay Joseph, bit number 253 from Holy Family. In lane 6, we have Miana Vernis, bit number 406 from Osita Jolly. And in lane 8, we have Melnea Wilson, bit number 223 from Enid Capron. You know, being out here today and yesterday, looking at the sprints, I was looking to see what the athletes were performing and getting, you know, or being ahead of the class so you can get an understanding in terms of where they are and the training and what's going on. But that whole concept has always been something that I look at. You being a former athlete and understanding the stages that an athlete goes through in races, what are some of the things you do try to let our athletes know as it relates to getting out of the blocks, coming around the curve, being a 200, 400-meter athlete? We know you are, well, currently you were one of our 400-meter record holders.
Right.
So you, that was one of your specialties. So this 150 is almost what you would use training-wise along with the 200.
Right.
So is there anything in particular you would tell an athlete running a 150?
So with the track athletes that we work with, we try to, especially with Delano Williams, you know, we try to express to them, like, you know, you look at it as a puzzle. You have to put the pieces of the puzzle together to complete the picture. You know, so everything has to be, I guess, in order. When they had the development meet a few weeks ago, I spoke with one of the athletes, and, you know, he was running the 400, and I told him how, okay, well, you kind of mess up the start, but the 400 is one of the races where you have time to make it up. You know, I said your mistake was you mess up your start, and then you try to put all your energy in the first couple meters. I said, you have 400 meters to make up for that.
Yeah.
You could have gradually make up and then make your moves where you had to make your moves. But I said, you know, don't beat yourself up about it. It's just a learning experience. I said, I've run the 400 for years, and I still haven't perfected it. It's just one of the things where you have to realize what works for you, what's your strategy.
All right, guys, and they're off. Coming off the band first, we see the athlete from Mosita Jolly seems to take control of this race out in front, powering down the track. Also, she's been chased by the athlete from Adelaide AMLO. And also, Enid Capron is making a push at the end. But they're going to stagger it. The way is going to end. Cedar Jolly, Adelaide AMLO, and Enid Capron, followed by Provo Christian and Richmond Hills. The difference for me with the 150 is that you don't have the full curve. You
right.
have the middle of the curve and coming around. So do you think lane does make a difference even in the 150? Because the 200, it definitely makes a difference, because if you're on the inside, you can actually see all of your opponents. As opposed to the 150, it's like you're in the middle of the curve. So you're only focusing on that half and then onto the straightaway.
I think it does, especially for the outer lanes. The strategy has to be a bit different where how you swing off to the curve. If I'm in lane one, then you know my angle of attack to swing into the curve is much different than the person who's in lane six or lane eight. You know, so I think the small stuff like that that makes a difference to where I can use the curve to set me up for a good finish on the straight. For example, like Noah Lyles, you know, he likes to run on the outside because he knows the quicker he can get into the straight, that is his bread and butter. That's where he makes up his time.
So, Creston, him getting beat in the 60 meters indoor, do you take anything from that, or is it just one of those things?
No, because I feel like he accomplished what he wanted to accomplish. Well, partially, I know he wanted to win, but he came in there, he went in there and left with a PB.
Oh.
If you are a 200-meter runner, and the 100 is not your specialty, and you can run 6.4, I feel like there's nothing to be mad about. there's nothing to be mad about.
But I think for Christian Coleman, it was way more for him.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. He had a lot to prove.
Yes.
He had a lot to prove.
You know, I mean, he's been second fiddle to
right.
for the longest. Because before, no, for Lyles, he was the man to be the next
big thing.
And
then
out of nowhere, Lyles just bust on the scene, and that was pretty much it. You really hear his name called anymore. But then also, you remember now, in those situations, like when we had Wilkes here, we were talking, he said, one of the craziest things he heard, Usain Bolt had said, remember when they, when they did the 400 meters, and they were telling the guy, in his first four steps, I'm going to catch you.
Don't worry, I'm going to catch you.
Like, that is crazy.
Most definitely.
Guys, this is heat 3 of 3. Girls, 8 to 9, 150-meter dash. In lane one, we have Eunice Stroll, bit number 361 from Una Clinton. And lane two, we have Jahira Musgrove, bid number 317, Iris Stubbs. Kai O'Neill in lane three from Community Christian, bid number 109. Kylie Braxter in lane four from Thelma Lightburn, bid number 535. Jatea Elsius, bid number 172 from Eliza Simons. All right, guys, in there off. Coming off the curve first, we have the athlete from Mosita Jolly, but the athlete from Una Glinton, and also giving chase, is the athlete from Provo Christian. She's out in battle with the athlete from Eliza Simons. And guys, this is going to be a very close one.
Race.
Very, very close one. But it looks like Eliza Simons is going to be able to hold her off at the end. And then we have Provo Christian coming in. Looks like Richmond Hill taking third, unofficial. So if you were wondering, that was Jatea Elsius from Eliza Simons, bid number 172, taking first place. And from Community Christian, that was Kai O'Neill, bid number 109, taking second place. And from my point of view, unofficial, Kayla Thomas from Richmond Hill, bid number 512, taking third. Again, guys, that's unofficial. Yes, Mr. Gallas, I was saying, in a situation such as that, where you know who that young man is, he tells you in your first four steps, that got to be nerve-wracking for you.
My first four steps?
Like, nobody could never my first four steps.
I think, too, but that comes with, you know, disciplining, understanding that regardless of what happens, you have to run your race. You have to. Because you could beat me in the first four steps, and I still catch you at the end. You know, it's just one of them things where you got to still stick to the plan, trust your coach, kind of listen to your body and push through where you need to push through. I think that's one of the big things of it.
That's crazy. But, I mean, here it is today. Yesterday we were looking at some of the softball throws. And I think some of the kids, man, they really got an idea in terms of what they needed to do and how to do it. And we didn't have much wind.
Right,
so the ball
right.
really traveled yesterday. So I'm looking to the east now to see particularly what we have. Our flags are beginning to fly a bit. So the breeze might have picked up today. So I want to see if that would affect. But I think this is the older crowd. Yesterday it was the 8 to 9. This should be 11 to 12. So see what happens there with that whole situation. But that was a heck of a 200 meters for the girls. And we should have the boys coming up 8 to 9, 150, meter dash. This is, again, event 10, boys 8 to 9. So this is going to be heat 1 of 4. In lane 1, Nathaniel Newman from Osita Jolly, bid number 418. We got Bradley Vinar from Richmond Hill, bid number 532. And lane 3, we have Denard Mighty from Community Christian, bid number 119. Dante Simmons from Doris Robinson, bid number 128. Andy Entwine in lane 5, bid number 231. From Enid Capron in lane 6, bid number 192. Adonai Carter from Eliza Simons. In lane 7, Cody Weir, bid number 383 from Ona Glinton. And in lane 8, Paulison Paul, bid number 164 from Elite School. All right, guys, and this is heat 1 of 4 for the boys, 8 to 9, 150 meters. So my question to you is, I know this is a pretty fairly new event. I think this is going into maybe the fourth year or third year.
Yeah, I think it's the third year, yeah.
I know we didn't have this back then in terms of it, but putting on such an event like this for our younger kids, I think this helps them to fully understand. Like if you're at your school and you're running, beating everybody, this now tells you where you are,
right?
Especially
right.
where you match up against other schools best. So for us to take it back to that aspect, does this, in your opinion, might form rivalries? Because you're leaving the primary school stage and you're going to go on to high school. Do you think that takes you into that, like, oh, I was running against him at primary school levels and he was beating me. Now this is my opportunity to get back at him.
I do think so. You know, especially shout out to the coaches because I think, and I asked the question yesterday, I was like, you know, I know how to train old athletes, you know, old athletes and adults. So I really think it's interesting their philosophy of how do they train primary school kids. I think that's incredible. And to be able to have that skill, you know, kudos to them. But I think being able to learn that competitiveness from this age will definitely take it into, you know, into high, you know, even Carifta and then further past that, you know, for the people that go to school in the States, the NCAAs and stuff like that. So I do think it's a good stepping stone into the bigger ranks, whether small or big.
See, and that's the thing that I say, the hats off to them, like you say, training these kids, because kids are going to be kids.
Right.
They want to run around and play. They don't want to be in nothing structure at this point. But for them who can get it done, man, definitely, definitely kudos to you guys for being able to get it done. But, I mean, right now they're down on the track. So the athletes are on the mark.
Now in the set position. Oh, false start. It seemed to be lane
and they're not stopping.
Six.
And they're not stopping.
And they had to resend them. I think that's the thing.
These kids don't care about no start of the gun.
Yeah,
no
yeah,
finish
yeah,
line.
Yeah.
I'm no, we're going. We are going. Once you say go, that's it. There's no ready. It's set go. We ready. So you said from your point of view, it might have been lane six.
Yes, I think it was. I think it was lane six.
In lane six, that is Anai Carter, bid number 191 from Eliza Simons. Talking about it now, Rayvon Black. So in this situation now, the four starters won. Do you think Nav set the stack in?
I'm not too sure if they fully understand how that aspect of it works. But I think there's a bit of nervous going on over there.
Well, like I said again, you're now running against athletes you've never seen before.
Right.
That in lies the issue because you've never seen these athletes before. You know, saying this now is like, okay, these are not normal faces that I haven't seen.
Right.
But I mean, Wilkes was like, this is his favorite part. Once that the sets, he looks around to see who's kind of
rattled,
he attacks from that point. I'm like, no, bro, you were already in a nervous position based on the fact that you're here.
Right.
And then to have a false start, your mind goes somewhere. He said, no, he lived for that. He loves that aspect of it. I'm like, no. All right, they're down in this set position. Let's go to the race.
Oh, they stand up. For me, I think all the nerves kind of got into it. When it got to the point where the starter was like set, at that point I was like, look, there's no turning back now. You know,
you gotta go.
Nervous or not nervous, I just got to go. And I think that was kind of what helped me. Okay. My races.
All right, guys, they're back down in the set position, the start position. Can we get to the race, please?
Oh, they're setting up again.
Yes, guys, if you're just tuning in, this is boys 8 to 10, 150-meter dash, heat 104.
And they're off now. A good push by lane 5. Lane 2 seems to be coming good on the inside. Oh, lane 5. We have a push from lane 7. This is a good race.
Enid Capron is out in front, followed by the athlete from Ona Glinton.
That was a really good race, really good race.
So in your mind, the athlete from Enid Capron clearly ran away from the field and not being contested. Yesterday, we had some situations to where this guy was clearly ahead of the whole field, but he stopped to turn around.
Right.
And not paying attention, the other athlete just
blew past him.
I'm like you say, it's hard to teach them these things, but they got to understand. And I think, and we were saying that if we had fans in the crowd, they would have cheered him on and said, hey, somebody's coming. Sometimes, you know, in your mind, you listen for footsteps, but some of us have the tendency
to look around,
to kind of understand where your opponent is or where the challenge is coming from. But right there, he had no reason to worry because he was completely out in front, not a person to challenge. But from what we saw, we understand that the athlete from Enid Capron took first place. Then Ona Glinton came in at second, not sure because Richmond Hill and Osita Jolly was jogging for third. So this is unofficial, folks. We are not too sure what it is. But as soon as we get the information and we can bring you our start list for the finals, you guys will have a better picture in terms of where we are. Again, if you're just joining, give you point standings. And in 17th position, Mills Institute with 1 point. In 16th position, Bass Institute, 2 points. In 15th, Doris Robertson Primary with 3. In 14th position, Provo Middle with 8. Elite in 13th with 9. Community Christian Academy and in 12th with 12 points. Provo Christian School in 11th position with 13. And 10th position, Thelma Lightburn Primary with 17. Hubert James Primary in 9th with 18. Iris Sturbs is in 8th place with 23. INT Pratt is in 7th with 30 points. Richmond Hill Preparatory, 33 in 6th position. And the 5th position, Eliza Simons with 44. And 4th position, Osita Jolly Primary with 50. And in third place, Adelaide Amlo with 50. In third place, Adelaide Amlo with 50. And in second place, we have Enid Capron with 87. And out in front, We have Ona Glinton with 105 points. And this is only through 45 events, folks. Only through 45 events. That is the point standing just thus far. All right, guys. Next on the track should be heat 204, always 8 to 9, 150-meter dash. In lane 2, Sean Pratt, bit number 530 from Richmond Hill. In lane 3, Fabian Morency from INT Pratt, bit number 289. In lane 4, Garfield Gary, bit number 95 from Charles Hubert James. In lane 5, we have Lamar Forbes, bit number 327 from Iris Stubbs. And in lane 6, we have Gravesley Antoine, bit number 232, Enid Capron. And in lane 7, we have Antoinette Jolly, bit number 118 from Community Christian. All right, guys, it was a bit of a rain this morning, but the sun is beginning to come out and really kind of give us a, hopefully we'll have a good day out here in terms of the weather conditions. You know, hopefully we might see, I know we have junior records, but do we have records at this stage?
Yeah, there should be for sure. There should be some records somewhere. I'm not too sure who we would reach out to that for, but there should be some record.
I mean, definitely, because this set out here that we see, there should be definitely some records somewhere, somehow.
Right. Because each year, the generations do get faster and faster.
Yes. And guys, if you're tuning in, last year we had 18 schools. This year we have 21 schools participating. Again, 18 last year, 21 this year. And I guarantee you,
progress.
We can definitely get bigger than this.
That's progress.
Very, very. And so imagine, this is a total of 575 athletes you're going to see over a three-day period.
Yeah.
So I want to give a shout-out to TC3A Sports Commission for being able to control such a large group over a three-day period and get them through all of their events. That takes a lot of team effort. So shout-outs to you guys for being able to get this thing done.
Yeah, as an athlete, you know, they just kind of told us, hey, be at the airport at this time. Come, you show up, you run. Now being on the administrative side of it, I've seen a lot of work that has gone into it. You know, so shout out to the Sports Commission, shout out to the TC3As, you know, shout out to the Red Cross, they're here with our emergency services, you know, the media team to be able to produce this and have it live, you know. So kudos to everybody for putting this on for another year.
Definitely.
I should say, you know, the same with Inter High and just all our Inter High school sports that we put on at the commission with
all
our
right.
sponsors.
They're down in the set. See if we get to the race.
They're off.
From the stagger, we can see the athlete from Masita Jolly is completely out in front. He is now being challenged by the athlete from Community Christian.
He's
but
coming.
Edith Capron is also
he's
pushing.
Coming.
He's definitely
going
pulling
to
up.
Line.
It's going to be
line.
A, it's going to be a photo
to
finish.
Line.
Yeah, I think he might have taken him at the line. So it's close between Masita Jolly and Christian Community. But I think coming in third place, that might have been Enid Capron coming in at third. But his form is kind of unorthodox
for his
dry face. But you know, again, they're kids, and there's an opportunity to correct that whole process.
But crazy enough, I've seen a lot of young athletes here with good running mechanics.
Wow.
You know, their running mechanics where they drive their elbows all the way back and forward and they plant their feet properly on the ground. I think that is a very good, remarkable thing to the coaches that are working with them, even to the athletes that have a natural thing for that. But it's definitely a good sign.
Like I said again, that shows you that they're teaching them the basics, the fundamentals of the sport in order for them to be able to, you know, propel themselves. Because I think yesterday watching the 400 meters, I was impressed watching these young kids be able to do, and then they understood when to break.
Right.
So that really shows that your coach is putting in the work with you because, like you said, most of us don't understand when to break or not to let a guy get away that far away from us. All right, guys, we have on the track now, this should be heat 3 or 4. Again, boys 8 to 9, 150-meter dash. In lane 1, we have Fredson Jean-Baptiste from Adelaide AMLA, bit number 33. Tyler Wins from Provo Christian, bit number 462. In lane 3, we have DiMaggio Fulford, bit number 93 from Charles Hubert James. In lane 4, Wendell Registry, bit number 381 from Ona Glinton. In lane 5, William Vargas from Thelma Lyburn, bit number 571. In lane 6, we have Snyder Jacinthe, bit number 330 from Iris Stubbs. And in lane 7, we have Joseph Jr., 154.
Lactic acid. I always wonder, like, do kids feel lactic acid? Because they don't seem to respond the way our bodies respond to it. I was like...
No, they definitely, they don't seem to work
right,
with them.
Right, you know,
no,
like...
Not at all. It definitely don't work with them. But I mean, for me, like you say, for them, they're just having fun. They're not
right,
even thinking
right,
about
right,
anything.
Right, right,
after
right.
I said, I don't know what that is.
Right.
Lay, you feel all right? Let's go. Let's just run. But coming out here, I mean, for you, me personally, loving the idea of you being able to give back and understanding where you are and being able to reach back and say, hey, let me give back to the next generation so they can not only get to where I am, but surpass where I went. And I think that, you know, any athlete that gives back, I want to commend you guys for giving up your time and you know, your skills and understanding of the sport to our younger generation and getting them to the point where, hey, I did this. So you can do it better than I did when I had the time. Because I think what we see here and the opportunities they have, we didn't quite have this
right.
growing up, per se.
Right.
So I would love for them to take advantage of every opportunity that's given to them in order for them to propel themselves to be better athletes, better students, all the above.
Right, I preach that to them all the time.
All right, guys, they're in the set position.
And they're off. Oh, there seems to be two guys in the same lane.
Yeah, well, that's a problem right there. But we have Una Glinton, and that seems to be Adelaide Amla, but Una Glinton is pulling forward, and Adelaide Amla is going to be a close one to the end. It's going to be a, well, Una Glinton is edging. So it's Una Glinton, Irish Stubbs, well, Una Glinton, Adelaide Amla, and Irish Stubbs. But that was going to be a tight one for a second. Now, in this situation, I don't think we should go with the penalization for
right.
You know, these are kids.
Right.
They still don't necessarily understand that. So there shouldn't be any, you know, penalization for running in the lane or, you know, the four stars, yes, it's completely obvious.
Right,
but
right,
we would
right.
correct that. But the lane situations, no. Because, Christ, some big people don't know how to stay in the
right,
lane. So.
Right, right, right. That was one of the questions I kind of asked one of the officials yesterday. I said, you know, well, when do you raise the flag? It's like, do you raise the flag for the athletes that stop? He was like, no, just kind of they run in their own lane.
My,
I was like, okay,
my point
well.
Exactly. All right, well, guys, just so you kind of understand what took place just now, that was Wendell Registry from Una Glinton taking first place in that race. And it was a really tough race, I must say. The athlete also from Adelaide Amlo, Fredson Jean-Baptiste, gave him a chance at the finish, but Wendell was able to hold him off. And as you can see, the athletes are leaving the 150 and they're coming back here to the board jump. So, like I said again, they don't get tired.
Right, right, right.
All right, guys. Next on the track is heat 4 of 4. Boys 8 to 9, 150 meters. We have in lane 1, Tyson Joseph from Doris Robinson, bit number 127. In lane 2, Wilson Noel, bit number 419 from Aseda Jolly. Bradley Pierre-Lewis in lane 3 from INT Pratt, bit number 309. In lane 4, Cameron Gardner, bit number 29, Adelaide Amlo. In lane 5, Herbie Bryce, bit number 553 from Thelma Lyburn. In lane 6, Masario Hamilton, bit number 197 from Eliza Simons. And in lane 7, Sherwin Dupree, bit number 445 from Provo Christian. Once again, guys, this is heat 4 of 4, boys 8 to 9, 150 meter dash. But you know what's amazing to me? Being as young as they are and understanding going through the rounds.
Right,
you
right. That, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because, I mean, for me, put them in the heat, they're going to run the same way they're going to
right,
run.
Right, 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 right.
So getting them understanding this now that your body goes through rounds, which makes perfect sense. You know, you have the prelims, the semis, the finals.
Right.
So if you go through this now, when you get up, you know, through it, you fully understand and grasp. Okay, this is what coach was saying from before.
Right.
So now I got that whole thing with me. I can move forward.
And it's kind of good, too, because, you know, back in the day when I was running and I would watch my predecessors, you know, people like Michael Johnson, they had 4 and 5 rounds before they got to the finals. So to see now that it's only two rounds and then the final to show how the sport of track and field has
changed.
Right. Definitely evolved for sure.
Well, like I said again, you know, what's the thing if it doesn't evolve? It has to evolve.
Right.
You know, in order for you to get better, you go through the whole process and you understand. So you would have known that, okay, today if I ran this by X, Y, and Z, I should
right,
be able
right.
to, you know. Like, guys, they're down on the they're down on the track. All right,
oh,
and they're
off. From lane two. Oh, look at the athlete in lane five.
All the way off the band already. Oh, I see the Jolly is making a push on the out.
Oh, wow. Look at lane one.
Lane one is there, but Ainti Pratt is holding. Sorry, Talma Leibman was holding his own, but he falls second place to Osita Jolly. Talma Leibman. And then also, that was Osita Jolly. So that was a pretty good run. That's a pretty good run. But lane five got out, and I don't think, he was out for a bit, and I don't know what happened.
Right.
Getting into the straight, the athlete from Osita Jolly was able to power. No, sorry. That was Doris Robertson that passed him. Tyson Joseph had passed him about maybe 30 meters to go and pulled even and kind of edged him out at the line. So for me, in those situations, you know, you look at it, and then you'd be like, okay, what the heck just happened? Like,
right, right.
But again, this is a heat. You don't take too much from it. It's like, okay, you go into the final now. I made a mistake in the heat. I can now correct this going forward. So I'm hoping, you know, the coaches will see it and actually explain to them, hey, this is what you did, but going into the finals, this is how we're going to correct that and
right.
make sure we don't make that same mistake again. Guys, coming up next, we're moving now to the 200 meters. This is going to be girls 10 to 11, 200 meter dash. Now, I know we spoke about you with the 400 meter prowess, but you started off, well, HJ wise, you know, you did the one, the two,
right.
the four, and the four by one. But how did the four get to become your favorite particular event or the event that you ended up now, you know, taking in and honing your skills in and being a racket holder for Turks and Caicos in that particular event?
When I, my senior year of HJ, which was 2011, I got second in the 100, but I won the 200. Mm-hmm. So, and I think after that, we had a development meet. That's when we had the Pistons versus the Panthers clap job. And I think I got second in the 200. I was like, you know what? I may be a 200 meter runner. You know, and I went to Jamaica and I heard the times that the other guys were running, and I was like, maybe I'm not so much a 200 meter, you know? It was like a reality check. And then, you know, so my coach was like, you know, like, I think you could be a 400 meter runner. So you had to train for it. And I remember I left, they had Carifta Trials that year. I ran 51.14. I got second at Carifta Trials. Papa from Clement Howell at the time.
Okay.
He beat me. He ran 51.12. So he got to run the 400 at Carifta. He set the national junior record. And I'm running the 4x1, but I got to Jamaica, and I think my first year I ran 50.2. And then my coach was like, yeah, you're a 400 meter runner. So, yeah, it went on from there.
You see, because like, I watch our kids and going through these races. I mean, it's kind of early to say what
right.
part would be your race because you're young and energetic. You're going to just go and do everything
right,
they tell you
right,
to do. You
right.
don't really think about that. But you do know as you go through the different stages as into, okay, which one I like more, and then, you know, that comes at the later stage. So right now, it's just them just
right,
getting
just,
out and running.
Just having fun, which I like. I do applaud them for having fun, you know. It's not something I had growing up. There was no inter-primary.
No,
you had sports day, and then you made the inter-high team.
But you know something that I think would make sense if we do a flip in terms of doing, do you think it makes sense doing inter-primary first, then bringing on the inter-high, or the structure should stay as it is?
Inter-primary is a lot more work than inter-high. it's a bit tough to, because this is like our last kind of major sporting event of the school year.
Okay.
It is kind of hard to go through it, but to go through this, then have to go through Inter High might be a little tough on the people that organize it. So for now, I'm okay with how it works. But I think it works out how it works out. But then if we were to have Inter High this late, there may be conflict of when Carifta and other stops happen. You know? So I think it works out pretty well.
All right, guys, on the track right now, heat 104, girls, 10 to 11, 200 meter dash. In lane one, Deborah Campbell from Community Christian, bit number 103. In lane two, Nakisha Malcolm from Enid Capron, bit number 220. And in lane three, Monisha Joseph from Osita Jolly, bit number 398. In lane four, Amira Green, bit number 501, Richmond Hill. In lane six, Jessica Gabriel, bit number 309, Iris Stubbs. And in lit name, Jadora Adams, bit number 81 from Charles Huber James. And in lane seven, we have Daronique Hanfield, bit number 12 from Adelaide Amlo. Once again, guys, that is heat 104, girls 10 to 11, 200 meter dash. And for me, I mean, you know, you speak about this. Yes, I know there might be some sort of jogging or jousting with the Carifta Games in terms of when it might be. So I guess maybe the structure was put in place for that same particular reason.
Right.
Because most of these events happens after schools have their major
or
individual track and field events. Then you pool together and kind of bring on this event. But for me, I mean, one of the things that I've been saying and I continue to say in terms of where we are with our athletes, we've always had raw talent here in Turks and Caicos.
Most definitely.
And to actually see that raw talent now get honed into becoming that athlete, it brings you joy. And I'm sure you can relate to that, seeing Turks and Caicos win a medal in the relay in at Carifta Games.
Right.
That was like, relay, we ain't doing that in no relay.
It's so crazy how you said that. I had a conversation, the boys had a conversation, I think it was yesterday, if not Monday, and we were talking about how, because even though I'm not an athlete, I still try to stay fit, so I, you know, have my regular weekly gym sessions. And we're in the gym, and I was like, man, if I knew what I knew now in the gym when I was a track athlete, things would have been much different. Because we went in the gym, and, you know, there was no structure to what we did. It was kind of just like, yo, we can do some bench press, we can do some squats, we can do some calf raises. So there was definitely just natural talent. If I knew what I knew now when I was in the gym, I think everyone would have been better athletes.
Well, like I said again, I mean, you look back over the days and the athletes that we've had, and if they had the opportunities these athletes had today, it would have been a whole different story. You can imagine, I don't know if you were around with the Levendior Baptiste, better known as Pabush. Then we had guys like Lionel Barranco.
Right.
You know, Ticker. Everybody knows Tyroy Smith, Ticker. Alicia Mizik, Anika Harvey, Rosanna Henry. You know, those athletes, to me, back then, had this opportunity or to be placed on this spotlight, I think we would have been completely far ahead as it relates to Turks and Caicos being on the map, track and field-wise.
I think it's also not just track and field. I think all sports-wise, you know, especially with the upcoming sports reforms department, you know, myself, Denano Williams, Tyler Emanuel, you know, Jada Barranco, I think them guys do a good job of how we, because right now we kind of all in charge of our own sports. You know, I help out with football, the team helps with football, we have basketball, Denano kind of takes on with swimming, softball. So I think what we do as a department itself helps along with all the stuff, you know, cause we do reach out to a lot of sports. Like I said, 2 weeks ago, I was in Antigua with the national football team. You know, Coach Tyler is with them today as they travel to Anguilla for their games. You know, so what we do as sports performers is we help athletes to prepare and compete and train at a high intensity level to the best of their ability. So whether that be strength and conditioning, you know, speed and agility, you know, plyometrics, you know, rehab, prehab, all that stuff. All that stuff kind of incorporates what it is that we do. And in fact, we just secured a worldwide athletic database. When we train athletes and the coach comes like, hey, well, what are your stats? I just simply type up the name and I just print the card of what it is that athlete does. Oh, he does this in the bench press. He does this in the 40-yard dash. He can squat this. He can jump this high. He can throw this. He generates this much power when he throws. So, you know, we are taking a big step forward So,
and that's what I'm talking about. That's a whole athlete profile right there for any coach that comes in. You definitely want to be able to present that.
Right.
And, you know, days gone, we had that. You write that on a piece of paper or something like that.
Yeah.
Sort. But to be able to pull it up, stats or his or her stats, and be able to pass that on to a coach, that would do wonders for them in terms of the coach understanding where the athlete currently
is.
And where, you know what I'm saying? So that doesn't place them in a box to where you have no idea what his athlete can do.
And with the database, too, it also shows where breaks. So he'd be like, okay, well, on the 16th of March, I see a decrease in this. I'd be like, well, coach, during that week, I had inter high. You know, I wasn't in the gym. Or, you know, so the program, the database shows all that. So it's a good step forward for the athletes. We just secure that, and I think we implement that this coming Monday.
That's perfect. I mean, like I said again, that goes to show you how much sports has transcended and moved on to bigger scenes in terms of, you know, where it's just, back in the day, it was just writing down a piece of paper.
Right.
We've now gone fully electronic, because before we were hand timing our athletes. We never fully understood what they were running. But we're going to go to the track now for the 200 meters, girls, 10 to 11. All right, they're asked to stand. Like I said again, now we move to the 200 from the 150. You're now fully at top of the curve.
Yeah.
Let's see if our athletes understand how you swing the curve. And they're off. Based on the stagger, the athlete in lane 7 seems to be out in front, but not to be outdone.
I think lane 2.
The athlete, lane 2 is beginning to pull around. That's the athlete from Enid Capron. And she is now taking control of the race.
Here comes the athlete in lane 5, though.
But Alcida Jolly is there, and also Richmond closing. Hills. So Iris Stubbs, Enid Capron, and they're going to end that way with Richmond Hills. So Enid Capron, Iris Stubbs, and Richmond Hills. Enid Capron dipped at the line. It's the first time I've seen that today.
So
she dipped at the line. So you understood they were in your hip. You're not sure where they were. So you dipped at the line to make sure I'm getting in here as I'm supposed to.
But it also, you know, quickens your time.
Yeah.
You know, like, if I dip to the line, that means I get a faster time.
Okay. Because, like I say, with what I've learned, like, sitting here and, like, saying, having the opportunity to be with you guys and pick your brains in certain situations, Wilkes was telling me that with javelin, there's no rule in terms of, you know, when you're running, if it's wind legal or illegal, the time doesn't count.
Right.
But with javelin, the wind factor doesn't bother you at all.
Right.
The wind could be at your back and you throw across the universe. That's
right. Still counts. I didn't know that.
He told me, I didn't have an idea of that either. So thanks for him giving me that knowledge. I had no idea of it. Okay, and this is heat 2 of 4, girls 10 to 11. We have out in front Bailey Forbes, lane 1, bit number 540, Thelma Lybron. And lane 2, we have Takara Lischester, bit number 471, Provo Middle. Haley Gardner, bit number 275, INT Pratt. Tian Hanfield, bit number 13, Adelaide Amlo. Susan Williams, bit number 188, from Eliza Simons. Bit number 311 in lane 6, Ruth Mania Jean, Iris Stubbs. We have Cherish Williams, bit number 49, Alpha Christian. Say once again, guys, this is heat 2 of 4, girls 10 to 11, 200 meter dash. I mean, in this event, for me, looking at it, like, especially going through the rounds, I mean, you don't normally running with, you know, depending on the heat.
Right.
You would put certain athletes in the heat, so you know exactly who you're up against and what you think. I mean, you don't take any athlete for granted. But I say that to say, if I'm in the heat, and I'm, as a female, I'm in the heat with a Sha'Carri Richardson or Shelly Ann Frazier, I know I gotta buckle up my spikes.
It's gonna be
a heck of a run.
Right.
So, you know, In these rounds, you know exactly where you are, but not saying that you're not going to run to try to, but you know exactly where you stack up in that particular situation.
That is true.
So I say that with our girls, we know exactly, you know, again, you're looking at different athletes. You don't know them
right.
because they don't go to your school. So in your mind now, this is all about me and my race. I have to focus on what I'm doing.
Right. I think they're about to get off.
Yes, and they're in their start position. And they're off.
That was a good push in the athlete in lane.
Yes, that's the athlete from Eliza Simons has gone out hard. And she is off to a blazing start. That's Susan Williams. She's completely out. But on the inside, the athlete from Thelma Lybrand is giving charge down the track and has surpassed her. So you have the athlete from INT Prep Provo Middle making a push, Osita Jolly, and Eliza Simons. But it's going to end with Thelma Lybrand, Provo Middle, and then you have Osita Jolly followed by Eliza Simons. Unofficial. Well, in that situation, though, what about the form? As you can see the replay, form seems to be out of whack. Adelaide LaPasta at the line, her form seems to be much better, and
right,
she's pumping.
With better form, you know. I think it all comes down to kind of coaching.
Yeah, well.
You know, I think coaching could help a lot with that. But I still think it's a good opportunity for them to come out here and have fun. You know, so I think that's one of the big things. Out here, they're having fun, and they're doing what feels good.
Yes, definitely. As you can see, at the line, she catches her at the line. Then Osita Jolly dips in as well, followed by Eliza Simons.
Right. Yeah, when based on what you piggyback what you said last time, in all my races in college, because we would get the heat sheets like the night before, like the day before, I would go and I look up the people in my races. I would look at their PBs, and I would see how fast they ran during the season. And from there, I go and I come up with my race strategy.
Of course.
You know, so these kids, they wouldn't really have time or completely understand that. So to them, it's kind of just like, yeah, once the gun goes off, I need to just run, which I think they do a very good job at.
Okay, guys, in this heat three of four, we have out in lane one, Sterling Telsier from Elite School, bit number 145. In lane two, we have India Rhodes, bit number 476 from Provo Middle. And lane three, we have Stacey Lalo, bit number 219 from Enid Capron. In lane six, we have Dalia Hall, bit number 395, Osita Jolly. In lane five, Demir Jarrett, bit number 504, Richmond Hill. And in lane six, we have Azalea Hannah, bit number 544, Thelma Lybrand. And in lane seven, Jamia Robinson, bit number 358, Una Glinton. Guys, this is heat three or four. Girls 10 to 11, 200-meter dash. So our athletes are and settling in their blocks. So we have some other events going on, guys. We have the girls' softball throw to the top of the field, the boys' long jump. So in terms of your strategy, I know you say you do rehab, prehab, so you and you do mobilities must right. be a part of your program, especially for our athletes to understand that certain body parts needs to be able to bend and move and get in that concept. But, you know, you guys being here in Provo, I'm sure your programs are not just limited to schools in Provo. You do try to take that to other islands as well?
Oh, yeah. So when we do a lot work, especially with the football team, I would send it to the coach and I implement it there. And when we go to the island, because we do a lot of work in other islands, but it'd be let's move school tours. I said, hey, I would tell the coaches, hey, we're in town tonight, you know, you can come out, send the athletes out, and we kind of show them. So I was showing like, hey, this is what we kind of do for warm-up. This is the program that I send them. This is kind of what we look for cues. Like, this is what we do. This is what you should do. You know, this is how you cue them. This is how you compensate them. This is how you correct them. And I kind of just leave them the program. You know, like, everything that I know, I didn't just learn it. And, like, I never knew it. So, like, I'm also about sharing my information, sharing my techniques. This is how it works. This is what we do. You know, you can switch it this way, and I give them the freedom. I just kind of give them the template and the outline of how it works. So that's how it works. I try to, so that way it's a fair playing ground.
That's true. Nobody gets the, nobody feels left out.
Right. What makes a difference between the programs is how consistent you are with it.
Well, definitely.
That's kind of how it sells it. It's consistency is key. And I must say that this is, I believe, the third year that the Sports Performance Department has been operational. And I can say that for the third year, we have had no injuries that came from sports performance.
That goes to show you that you guys are definitely putting in the work. So our athletes totally understand where they are and you know, getting their bodies right. Because that's your vessel in this whole process. And if you allow that to go down, then you're in trouble.
Right.
All right, we're down on the start.
The
access stand.
I think the gun jammed for a little bit.
So, question. I know this is weird, and I always ask this this question in terms of you watching these young athletes,
right,
even from the inter-high perspective in here. Do you see any athlete that reminds you of yourself in terms of their, you know, running and all that other thing?
I think, to be honest with you, all the athletes I see here, I wouldn't say they remind me of myself, but I think they are really in a better position to be better than I was. Because the opportunity that they have here, I never had this. I never had interprimary. You know, back then I had sports day at HA, then we had inter high.
Yeah.
Carifta, we may have Carifta trials. If not, you got picked from inter high. You know, on top of that, we have coaches who are more abreast about the modern training technologies. You know, on top of that, like I said, we have the sports performance department. And another, one of the big aspects of the department is not that we train athletes all the time, we have proper time for recovery.
All right. They're down in the set position, the 200 meters. And they're off. The athlete from Una Clinton seems to have gone out really hard. That is Jameer Robinson. But making based on the stagger, the athlete from Masita Jolly is also in the mix. And pulling forward now, here comes the athlete out in lane. She's completely out in front. And she is from Richmond Hills. That seems to be Demir Jarrett out in front, followed by Ms. Robinson from Una Clinton, followed by Osita Jolly. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3. We're going to have Richmond Hill, Una Clinton, Osita Jolly.
You know, one of the things I must commend the athletes on, they always run through the line,
yes,
regardless of what position they are in the
race. Doesn't matter.
They always finish the race.
Finish the race. That's it.
I must commend them for that. And the coaches that implement that.
That race kind of hard in the first 20 and getting into the middle of the curve. The athlete from Richmond Hill caught up and coming off the bend, they were neck and neck. But the stagger, you can tell, being in lane 7, it's kind of difficult when the person's in your inside and you're not being able to see her. So, as you see right now, Richmond Hills, if you're watching the replay, is powering down, well, all the way through the line, followed by Ms. Robinson from Mona Clinton, and you have Ms. Osita Jolly coming in third place. But that whole, like I said again, being in 7th is kind of hard because you can't see your inside.
Right,
you don't know who's coming, so you don't know what to do. And that position, to me, I think is an all-out sprint. So you want to stay ahead because you don't know what's coming. But if you, in your opinion, watching this in now, the 200 meters, I say lanes 4 and 5, sometimes 6, are the sweet lanes for that particular event.
I think 6. I think 6 is a good lane.
Because 6, you see everything.
Right. I think 6 is a good lane. You know, from lanes 1 to 4, you kind of got to work a little harder in the beginning. But, you know, the outer lanes, I think you kind of use the curve to do most of the work, and you just focus on the straight.
Yeah, but the lanes, I mean, don't get me wrong. People have won out of lane 7 and 8.
Right, I agree.
But, man.
I agree.
All right, guys. We now have heat 404, girls ages 10 to 11, 200-meter dash. All right, guys, in heat 404, like I said, girls 10 to 11, 200-meter dash. We have Veljanique Silva, bit number 183, Eliza Simons. In lane two, we have Layla Martinez, bid number 347, Provo Christian. Ivana Forbes, bid number 274, INT Pratt. Zaire Ardeen, bid number 427, Provo Christian. Namia Joseph, bid number 572, Wesley Methodist. In lane six, Aleah Williams, bid number 363, Ona Clinton. And in lane seven, we have Jody Lee Barbaru, bid number 130, Elite School. And then we have in lane eight, bid number 110, Kadira Robinson, Community Christian. Once again, guys, this is heat 4-4, girls 10 to 11, 200 meter dash. Okay, we still have a yellow flag at the start. Or at the finish, sorry. Rather. So, I mean, in terms of us out here, and like I said, watching all of this madness come together, I think, you know, our audience at home wouldn't kind of quite comprehend
what's going on.
Yeah, because you were to really be out here and actually see what we're seeing, because you guys are looking at the track, we get to see the full view, a full panoramic view of the field, and watching
just everything come to life.
575 athletes move around, and it's crazy.
You got the kids that are running over there. You have the group of officials that are working with the call room.
Definitely.
You got the kids on the back over there that are warming up. We got some jumping going on. We got some throwing over there. We have the tech team over here, medical over there. So it's just so much that's going on right now. But I think, crazy enough, that everything is working smoothly.
That's how it is. Like I
everything
say,
everything is just kind of flowing.
They always say it takes a village to raise a kid. So
right.
We are the village.
Right.
And these kids are here today.
I think everyone is doing a good job, you know. So kudos to, like I said, the sports commission.
Oh, definitely.
The TC3As, the officials, the medical team, the media, everyone. I think they're doing a good job.
I mean, to me, I love the idea of letting our kids get out and show their skills.
I think it's a good way, too, of reminding kids that, you know, you are a kid. Have fun.
Yeah, that's pretty much all it is. You definitely got to go ahead and have fun. Everything else is second nature to that. You've got to be able to have fun.
You know, that's one of the things that I do a lot of TED Talks. That's one of the things that one of the TED speakers talk about, that humans were made to run. That makes us different, because you know what makes the humans different from any other animal?
Okay, wait a second. We're down on the track. All right, guys, heat 404. Set. And they're off.
A good start from athlete in lane three.
Coming off the curve, based on the stagger, the athlete from Provo Christian seems to be completely out, but Osita Jolly is blazing off the tracks into the straightaway, followed by the athlete from Una Glinton. She's trying to make up the stagger, but Provo Community Christian is out, deadly out in front. Good run from the athlete from Una Glinton is powering her way into second position, and she will definitely end at second. So there you have
good
it.
Job.
You have Community Christian, first place, Una Glinton and second, and Osita Jolly in third position. That's a good run from Miss Williams, powering that, coming off the curve. She was a bit behind, but she was able to close the gap quickly into the straightaway and powered her way past the athlete for second place. As you can see in your replay, Osita Jolly clearly out in front, but Una Glinton was able to power through, arms pumping, legs moving, so that's definitely a good sign. You can actually see her cross the line in second place. So to me, like I said again, this is the heat, and these guys are really running, because, you know what I'm saying, one and two, you advance. That's fastest time you enter. So you want to just secure your place. Then, like you say, put your race together for the final to understand what needs to be done.
Right.
You would see on the inside the athlete from Eliza Simons taking fourth place in that event. As you can see, wildly on your screen, the athlete from Una Glinton clearly powering down the track, powering her way into second position, followed by Osita Jolly and Eliza Simons on the inside in lane one. Now, in that situation for me, you know what I'm saying, and sometimes there's nothing you can actually do when you're locked up and you've gone out too hard,
right,
and you have nothing left to give on the straightaway. That's basically when you start to gauge or know when, like you said, knowing your race, when to kick, when not to, you know what I'm saying, go out too hard, or don't allow your opponent to get too far away from you. That way they'll when it's time for you to catch, it's hard to get back into to contention.
At the when running the 400, and the coach always tell us at that point, the only thing you can do is pray. At that point, there's nothing you can do. Just, you know, pray, keep composed, and, you know, just finish the race through.
All right, guys, next on the track, we have event 12, boys, 10 to 11, 200-meter dash. This is going to be also heat one of four. It's going to be four heats in this event. And in lane one, we have Rashawn Lamont, bit number 416, Osita Jolly. Kadario Parker, bit number 56, Alpha Christian. Stuart Elsius, bit number 213, Enid Capron. Jariah Joseph, bit number 575, Wesley Methodist. Laquant Forbes, bit number 328, Iris Stubbs. Johnsley Josil, bit number 117, Community Christian. Lovingston Colin, bit number 374 from Una Glinton. And DeHanson Pierre, bit number 166 from Elite School. Once again, guys, heat one of four, boys 10 to 11, 200-meter dash. Again, guys, that's Lamont, bit number 416, Osita Jolly. Parker, bit number 56, Alpha Christian. Bit number 230, Elsius, in the Capron. Joseph, bit number 575. Lane 3, Forbes, bit number 323, Iris Stubbs. Bit number 117, Josil. Lane 6, Community Christian. And lane 7, Colin. Bit number 374, Ona Glinton. And in lane 8, Pierre, bit number 166, Elite. What is so crazy, you watch the young man, Lovingston. Yesterday, he ran. So his brother, name is pretty simple, similar. So the commentator goes, but wait, didn't he just run? I said, no,
that's his brother.
That's his brother. You know, you have the son on the end, yes, but, you know, they're completely different. They look alike, but they're completely different. We don't want to confuse the two.
Right.
Well, speaking of which, you're going to see him in their second heat. So you have Lovingston and you have Lovin. So it's big difference. So the son on the end makes the difference.
So the brother is running now.
Yes, the brother is running now. The brother is Colin. Yes, from Una Glinton in lane 7, and his brother is going to be in the second heat, and they're off.
So would they make them twins?
Yes, sir. Oh, okay. And they're off. And as I said, Lovingston is out in front all the way by himself. But based on the stagger, the athlete from lane 3 is giving a push onto the straightaway. It's going to be crazy. It looks
he's kicking.
Yes, it's Enid Capron and Una Glinton. But Lovingston seems to have the edge. He is going to pull away, taking this from start into finish. So it's going to end Una Glinton, Lovingston taking third. Wesley Mass coming in at four. A beautiful start by Lovingston in that race. And, you know, crazy enough, lane 7. Crazy enough, off the curve first, and you have the chance to now see your inside to make sure you can definitely get out and understand, hey, Enid Capron gave a good chase, but he had enough to further pull away. As you can see, Enid Capron doing all he can to pull even, but unfortunately ran out of real estate at the end.
It'll be a good race if the two brothers are in
final
4 and 5 tomorrow. Yeah, it'll be a great race. We'll see after this heat. Look forward to.
Well, like I say, he's done his job already. It's time for his brother now to do his job. So we definitely want to see what's going to happen there. But next on the track, guys, heat 2 of 4, boys 10 to 11, 200 meters. Lakeo Capron, bit number 288, INT Pratt. In lane 2, Justin Baisden, bit number 51, Alpha Christian. And lane 3, Rosie Cox, bit number 290, INT Pratt. In lane 4, Amir Sinclair, bit number 531, Richmond Hill. 5, we have Marvin, Community Christian. In lane 6, Lovins Colin from Una Glinton, bit number 373. And in lane 7, we have Aiden Parker, bit 37, Adelaide Amler. So this is going to be crazy right here. Let's see what happens. Let's see if Colin number two can book his ticket to the 200-meter final.
He has almost a similar lane draw as his brother.
Oh, yes. Brother was in seven. He's now in six. All right, guys, the sun is now fully back out, kind of drying up all the rain that we had this morning. That should definitely help our athletes in terms of them being able to get out and run a good time.
The wind is very calm today, too.
All right, guys, just before the race starts, I want to give a shout-out to our sponsors. We have Graceway Supermarket, Waterloo Holdings Investment Limited, Inter-Caribbean, Provo Water, Grace Bay Pharmacy, The Tuscany, Provo Beverages, and Royal West Indies Resort. Once again, Graceway Supermarkets, Waterloo Holdings Invested Limited, Inter-Caribbean, Provo Water, Grace Bay Pharmacy, The Tuscany, Provo Beverages, and Royal West Indies Resort. You know, the crazy thing is, like you say, I would love to see that because twins running against each other.
Right.
They must have a budding rivalry.
Right. It has been a healthy feud they have going on. Especially for the twin who probably thinks, oh, I'm older because I'm bigger.
So this is going to be crazy to see because this determines which twin is faster.
Right. And there are no marks.
Okay.
They're off.
The athlete from Provo, Christian, seems to be out blazing. Coming off the curve first, but off the stagger, we have the athlete from Osita Jolly on the inside. Sorry, that is Osita Jolly on the inside. Here comes Lovins off the curve, but that athlete from Provo, Christian, is going to definitely take it. We have INT Pratt on the outside. Lovins is making his way into, but it's going to be Provo Christian, Osita Jolly, Richmond Hill, and Una Clinton in that race. Sorry, so that was INT Pratt. Sorry, with the color, you might get a bit confused. But again, the athlete from Community Christian, that is John Slee Giselle. Check him out. His form coming in, cruising, in my opinion, not being bothered. But the race was to be held behind him in terms of those other athletes coming in and jockeying for position. In that race, you can see it right here now. The race for second or the place for second was almost kind of tough to call, but
right.
You know, the athlete from Miami Prep was definitely out in front. All right, guys, next on the track is going to be heat 3 or 4 for the boys' 10 to 11 200-meter dash. In lane 1, Dash Forbes, bid number 573 from Wesley Methodist. In lane 2, Chris Claude Lostill, bid number 157 from Elite. In lane 3, Josiah Henry, bid number 97 from Charles Hubert James. And we have in lane 4, Knight Backworth, bid number 485 from Provo Middle. In lane five, we have Johnson Jean, bid number 560 from Thelma Lybrand. And in lane 6, Jace Mullins, bid number 227 from Richmond Hill. And in lane 7, we have Rashano Cox Jr., Adelaide Amla, bid number 25. Coming into this race, of course, watching them run yesterday, the two favorites to keep your eye on. They're in lane by lane, Jace Mullings and Rashano Cox. Yesterday, they had a great showing yesterday, watching them run the 100 meters, or the 400 meters, sorry. So this is a bit step down, but again, same rule applies. Those are the two athletes to watch. And not taking anything away from any other athlete in this race, but those two athletes, based on what I saw yesterday, this should be a really good race.
Especially with them on the outside as well.
Yes. So they're getting the athletes set up in terms of getting the lane assignments right. Again, guys, if you're just joining in, this is heat 3 of 4 for the boys' event 10 to 11, 200 meters. Again, lane 1, Forbes, Wesley Methodist. Lane 2, Laura Still, bid number 157, Elite. In lane 3, Henry, Hubert James. In lane 4, Backworth, Provo Middle. In lane 5, Jean, Thelma Libran. In lane 6, Mullins, Richmond Hill. And in lane 7, Cox Jr.
They're down the blocks.
And they're off.
A stumble there from Mr. Cox.
Yes, a stumble from Mr. Cox, but nonetheless. Okay. Coming around, Mr. Cox seems to be out in front, but off the stagger. Here comes Mullings from Richmond Hill, but Osita Jolly seems to be completely out in front. Here comes now Mr. Cox in terms of his maturation in this race. Wesley Methodist seems to be out, but here comes Cox. Cox is turning on the jets, powering down the track. He's going to... That's going to end that way. Cox is going to take second. So we have in the first place, that seems to be, I ain't proud if I'm not mistaken, followed by Cox. Mullings didn't do a great job in that race. Not too sure what particularly happened there for him. But again, Cox, as I said to you, was the athlete to watch. And not taking anything away from any other school. But the young man out of lane 4, that seemed to be, Hubert James, lane 3, Josiah Henry. He took control of that race coming off the bend. Cox was trying to charge close, but didn't have enough to close out. So in this event, like you said, Cox stumbled coming out of the blocks. But the 200 meters is such a short race now to wear.
To make up, right. I think he did a good job of, you know, coming back from the stumble. You know, he pushed where he needed to, used the curve to set him up nice on the straight and came home.
All right, guys. Next on the track, heat 4 of 4, boys 10 to 11, 200-meter dash. In lane 1, Aiden Talbot, bid number 458, Preville Christian. In lane 2, Harry Phillips, bid number 493, Preville Middle. In lane 3, Don 420, Osita Jolene, bid number 233, Enid Capron. In lane 5, Aiden Skippins, bid number 204, Eliza Simons. In lane 6, Giovanni Joseph, bid number 561, Thelma Libran. And in lane 7, Corano Forbes, bid number 325, Irish Stubbs. Once again, guys, it's heat 4-4, boys 10 to 11, 200-meter dash. In lane 1 again, that is Talbot for Preville Christian, bid number 458. In lane 2, Phillips, bid number 493, Preville Middle. Outen in lane 3, bid number 420 for Cedar Jolly. Bean, bid number Skippins, bid number 204, Eliza Simons. Joseph, bid number 561, Thelma Libran. And in lane 7, Forbes, bid number 325, Irish Stubbs. They seem to be progressing lovely. We're here now at the 200 meters. This is going to be, the last one for the boys, 10 to 11. And then after this, we have the girls, 12 to 13. and they're off.
Oh, good start by the athlete in lane. Oh, he's moving the athlete in lane seven.
Oh, lane seven seems to be running away with this from Irish Stubbs.
Oh, wow. But look
that is Kavano Forbes. But lane two from.
It's going to be a battle. Proper
medalist giving a charge.
It's going to be a battle on the straight.
Oh, on the straight, it's definitely going to be a battle. This seems to be a tough race, but from the looks of it, Provo Medal seems to be completely out in front and holding his own. That's Henry Phillips, followed by the athlete from Irish Stubbs out of lane seven, running into, there you have it, Enid Capron and Eliza Simons. That's the way they're going to end. That was a beautiful run.
That was a good run.
In lane seven by Irish Stubbs out in front, but the athlete from Provo Medal powered his way down the track, taking himself into second position, followed by Enid Capron and Eliza Simons. So that is a good run, man, by skipping. It's a very good run.
It's going to be a nice finals.
It's definitely going to be a nice finals watching them. And I mean, if you go back to looking at the replay, Forbes was completely ahead of the pack off the cover. But based on the stagger, you would see Phillips coming into your screen off the straight. Off the cuff into the straight and having enough to pull forward. I mean, I don't know if that's to say where Forbes never saw him.
Right.
And probably attacks too late after he saw him. So that could be a combination of things. As you can see right there, they just kind of at the, say, 30-meter mark, it was kind of over from there because he had really pulled ahead. So I don't know if it was to the point where he didn't see him, didn't understand what was going on, but that was kind of crazy to actually see him run such a beautiful curve and get onto the straight.
That was a beautiful curve. That was a great strategy, too.
Attack the curve really, really, really hard.
That was a great strategy.
All right, guys, next on the track, event 13. This is going to be girls 12 to 13, 200-meter dash. In lane one, Gianna Green, bet number 214, Enid Capron. In lane two, Lydia Maritas, bet number 401, Osita Jolly. In lane three, Malaney Mitchell, bet number 507 from Richmond Hill. In lane seven, we have Adelia Pennell, bet number 547, Thelma Lybron. And in lane seven, we have Senator Jean Registry, bet number 357, Una Clinton. And then we have in lane six, the Sayer Ewing, bet number 106, Community Christian. And in lane seven, we have Manishka Dasteen, bet number 133, Elite School. Once again, guys, if you're joining in, this is heat 104, girls 12 to 13, 200-meter dash. Lane one, Green, bet number 214, Enid Capron. Lane two, Maritas, bet number 401, Osita Jolly. Lane three, Michelle, bet number 507, Richmond Hill. Parnell, bet number 547, Thelma Lybron. And in lane 57, Registry, Una Clinton. Lane six, Ewing, bet number 106, Community Christian. And in lane seven, bet number 133, Dasteen Elite.
Wind seemed to pick up.
Yeah, definitely the wind is picking up now. But luckily, the throws have concluded so far for the day, so that shouldn't affect anything right now. And I'm wondering if we're going to prepare for a bit of rain because there's a big cloud out in front of us. But nonetheless, let's just pray and hope that that's just a blowover and we can get back to action here at the National Stadium. And guys, again, this is day two of the 2024 Inter-Primary Championships here at the National Stadium in Providenciales. Still have an opportunity to come on down and take in the beautiful action. Or our folks out there, Radio Land and also via the web, you guys are tuned in live to giving you guys sights and sounds of this track event today. So now the weather is beginning to be getting a little chilly. So do you think this might affect our kids? Again, these young kids. Hey.
Right, I think... If they were aware of how it works, then maybe. I think for the most, they probably still would just go out there and run and have fun. If this were me in my athletic time, I probably would have gone somewhere, put on my sweats, you know.
Continue
my
warming
jacket,
up. Yeah.
Ride, you know.
Staying warm.
Doing additional warm-up strides and get ready to go.
Meals and test our endurance with the Island Walk runs.
Find out what keeps your body moving
and get fit with our community workouts.
We will get your fitness journey started, and if it works for you, push your limits.
Let's move, TCI.
It's Lionel Williams here, your Olympian. You know it was coming. It's the Inter-Primary School Track and Field Championships taking place March 19th through to the 21st right here at the National Stadium. I have Coach Tyler here. We have created our own champs because we are so excited to celebrate with you guys.
I'm battling Coach Delano to take my crown as the new Sports Day Champion.
Now there are three parts to this race. You have the potato sack race, the egg and spoon, and my favorite, the 40 meter dash.
Are you ready?
All right, guys, and we're back. Have to pay our bills, you know, give a shout out to our sponsors. As you can see right in front of us now, they're getting ready for the girls' long jump. And on the track right now, Mr. Garland, we have the girls 12 to 13, heat 104, 200 meter dash.
That was a full house, all eight lanes are filled. Off. Good start from the athlete in lane six. Look at the athlete from Wona Glinton.
Yeah, that is Nigene Registry from Wona Glinton. And
oh, she's taking
giving
lead.
A good run. She's coming from the bend, but the athlete
race
from
to the finish.
Provo Christian has pulled up on her. It's going to be one to the end, but Provo Christian is chasing her to the end, and it's going to end that way. Provo Christian. Then we're going to have Una Glinton followed by Osita Jolly. It's a pretty good run. I mean, got bunched up in the middle there, but, you know, nonetheless, second place is may not be where she wanted to be, but perfect for her to advance to the finals.
Right.
As you watch the replay, you can see they were neck and neck there for a bit. But the athlete from Provo Christian Community Christian was able to pull forward ahead of the athlete from Wona Glinton. As you can see right there, you have a full view of the field in terms of where the athlete stacked up.
Getting ready now for heat 204. it's 11 to 13, 200 meters.
All right, guys. In this heat, this is heat 204. In lane one, we have Kayla Carter, bid number 104 from Community Christian. In lane two, we have Carrie-Anne Seymour from Irish Star, bid number 319. In lane three, Michaela McIntosh, bid number 546, Thelma Liburn. And in lane four, Ranares Nunes, bid number 508, Richmond Hill. And in lane five, we have Rodasia Lewis, bid number 45, Alpha Christian. And in lane six, Ania Rigby, bid number 440 from Provo Christian. And Ucard Jean Baptiste, bid number 15, at lane AMLO. Once again, folks, this is heat 204 for girls 12 to 13.
They're off.
Coming off the cuff, that is the athlete all the way out in lane two. That's Jean Baptiste. Sorry, lane seven. But the athlete on the inside
from Community Christian is giving
a push on down the straight. But here comes the athlete from Adelaide AMLO. It's going to be a close finish. It's going to be a very close finish, but Adelaide AMLO is going to take that one, followed by Community Christian, followed by Richmond Hill, Enid Capron. All right, Irish Stubbs, sorry. That was a pretty interesting race,
yeah,
especially off the curve. They were a bit neck and neck jousting at the line, and I was interested to see if one of them would have been, used the dip at the line. But I guess it wasn't necessary for her. Her form was a bit tight upright, and as you can see, Adelaide AMLO powering herself into front jumping across the line, making sure that hey, I can secure this victory and on to the finals. There you go, right here. You have a full view in terms of what's going on. And she kind of just leaps across the line to make sure she gets herself into winning position. All right, guys. Hold on.
Just a slight weather delay, everyone. Should be a quick,
pass over
with the rain.
All right, guys. A little downpour here. Had to make some adjustments, but we're good. Back at it again. So Colin, you took me through your racing. Were you ever a field event athlete, or that's nothing you were interested in?
No, I did a little bit of a long jump and high jump for the administrator's house, one of the best houses in the H.J. Robinson system.
Okay, I mean, I know most athletes that sprinters, they don't do.
Right, they came out of, and most sprinters I know came out of administrators.
No, we're going to do this again.
I'm just saying, that was the house that I went. That was the house I was in for the 5 years of
And you're sitting here on national radio and say the sprinters came out of
Edmonds. Majority of sprinters came out of Edmonds. Now, you had a few of the outliers like Delano that made it. I think Delano was in Sherlock. But, I think majority of us came out of Edmonds.
Listen, as much as it's going to hurt me to say this, because I think this house that I'm going to call,
right,
they were very annoying in high school and still annoying to this day.
Crawford had
they set of sprinters as well,
right,
too.
I'm not knocking them. But I think majority of the athletes that came out of HJ came from administrators. I just think that's a fair call.
Okay. I mean, like I said again, your day, my day,
different. No, okay, different. That's a fair statement.
But I would give this to you. Sherlock had its crop of athletes.
They did have.
We had one of the most decorated athletes from a career of the standpoint, Mr. Lionel Barranco.
Okay, I'm not knocking that. I'm not knocking them.
No, I mean,
but in my time, for the 5 years that I was at HCA, administrators were the team that kind of was doing their thing.
I sure folks like Rita Williams and Maquita Carter were big or different, but that's different.
So what house was Maquita was not Edmonds?
No, I think Rita was in Crawford.
See, but Rita
was in Wood, if I'm not mistaken. So,
right.
Yeah.
Majority of the people in my time, they were in Edmonds.
Well, that's fine. I ain't worrying about that.
Right.
It'll be just fine.
Right.
We're not going to do that today. I don't want to get into that argument about houses because then you're going to come with the story that Sherlock never did this, and we're not going to do that.
I'm just saying.
But we're going to be fine. All right, guys, right now, but just for folks in radio land or also out here watching us on thing, the rain does never stop an event. It's only thunder.
Right.
I mean thunder.
And
lightning. Stops the event. So rain is not a problem.
Right. In the States, with the NCAA rules, for every lightning strike, there's a 45-minute delay. But other than that, the events are going on.
Yeah, so the rain doesn't stop particularly anything.
And I see some of the kids here, they're still participating with the long jump.
Yeah, of course. We have the jumps.
This is a good way to introduce the kids to the reality of international competitions.
All right, guys, if you're out there and you're watching us live on Facebook, there's a trivia question on the screen. Now, let's see how quick you guys are on your feet and win. Look at the question. What year did the career of the games occur in Turks and Caicos Islands? Guys, go ahead. Let's see who was the first to come up with this answer. And we're watching the feed, so we definitely would know who was first. So, again, what year did the career of the occur in Turks and Caicos Islands? You have 2006. 1998, 1959, and 2007. No, the first answer you gave, ma'am, was wrong. Yes, Rosanna Henry, you were first with 2007. That was right. But the Crafter Games was held in Turks and Caicos. That was 2007. But like I say again, guys, I mean, we shouldn't even allow her to answer. we shouldn't allow you to answer. But speaking of which, you were here at the time of the craft in 2007?
Yes, I was here. I would have been in second form. Crazy enough, I hadn't started my track career as yet.
What?
Yeah.
So when did your track career come alive?
2009.
So what were you doing the first 2 years?
Just my books.
I'm thinking you jumped straight into high school and hit the track running.
No, my first 2 years I was just, you know, more into my books, more into music. And then I think it was after a lot of athletes, because that was in my prime when we had athletes like Tyrell Skippins, Andy Shakes.
You would know that. Your class
right.
was a very competitive group.
Right.
You know,
right.
And we're going to talk about your class. Like you say, Terrell, the McKenzie.
Right.
I remember every year, those two would be the last two jumping at high jump. I'm like,
right.
What the heck is wrong with
and right.
running, they were doing the same thing in running.
Right.
So you had a whole, yeah.
Right.
Your class was crazy. Finally, all those guys you had to contend with in terms of running. So that was crazy.
But after them guys left, you know, we had sports day and the coach was just like, hey, look, we need somebody to just fill in the heat. He was like, just go out there and run. I went out there. I got second in my heat. Cadell Ingram beat me in my heat.
Okay.
And then it's so crazy. I remember that year Jason Okoye had just moved to Turks, and we didn't know much about him. We just knew he was just this athletic kid that flips and stuff from Jamaica. And I remember we all lined up, and we were just all frightened. I think he came fourth in the heat, in the race. It was Ifani, Cadell, and myself. And then from there, I made my first inter-high team, and that's how my track career kind of started.
All right, guys, on the track, this is heat 3 or 4, girls 12 to 13, 200-meter dash. In lane 1, we have Dina Cadet, bid number 388, Osita Jolly. In lane 2, Irene Hall, bid number 310, Iris Stubbs. In lane 3, we have Zakiya Sanders, bid number 21, Adelaide Amler. In lane 3, we have Elena Stenbrook, bid number 479, Provo Middle. And we have in lane 5, Nisha Petit, bid number 282, INT Pratt. In lane 6, we have Zola Gray Ewing, bid number 251 from Holy Family. And in lane 7, we have Rose Fadia Raymond, bid number 143, Elite. Once again, guys, this is the heat 3 or 4, girls 12 to 13, 200 meter dash. So, question for you now.
Yes.
Having the weather change and you was taken off the track, now you're back on. Does this, do you think in any sense affects what the athlete is able to do, or they should, like you said, with you, you would have moved off, kept your sweats on, and keep moving and keeping yourself warm.
Right. I think right now it's more mental than anything, because now you have to be mentally prepared where the weather cannot affect you. I think at one point I was watching a race, a Diamond League, and I think just before the 100 meters, like, the weather had just dropped and they were just standing there in the rain, and at that point there's nothing you can do. Just to be mentally prepared. So I think you just got to block out distractions, go in there, get in your blocks, and still run your race.
All right, guys, we're definitely waiting on the start now. Again, we still have the long jump here with the girls in front of us. That seems to be the age group 8 to, I think that should be 10 to 11 out in front. And then on the opposite side of us, there's another flight going on. So we have a lot of jumping going on right now. Sadly, well, goodly, the wind has died down a bit. The race is off.
They're off. Oh, great start from lane 5.
Lane 5, that would be Petit from INT Pratt coming off the curve. She is definitely out in front by herself. But on the inside from Iris Stubbs, making a push is Irene Hall, and she is going to take her over on the middle of the jump. This might be a close finish because they are neck and neck. It seems like Petit has regained the lead and going into the, yes, definitely, it's going to end
good
that
job.
Way. So we have Petit from INT Pratt, Iris Stubbs. We have Irene Hall taking second place in that race. Yes, it's unofficially, but that's where we stacked up. As you can see in your replay, for a minute, Hall had her, but Petit was able to hold her off at the end for a strong finish. Now we're going to move into, this should be heat 4 of 4 on the track. Girls, 12 to 13 in this particular heat. Okay. Okay, so we have box 1 is going to be empty in this heat. In lane 2, we have Sophie Forbes, bid number 213, Enid Capron. And in lane 3, we have Amani Hall, bid number 252, Holy Family. In lane 4, we have Laura J. Lee Duremus, bid number 271 from INT Pratt. And in lane 5, we have Vashti Gasing, bid number 432, Provo Christian. And we have in lane 6, Aseo Williams, bid number 364, Una Glinton. And in lane 7, we have G.L. Paul, bid number 139, Elite School. Once again, guys, this is heat 4-4, girls 12 to 13, 200 meter dash. And after this should follow closely by, should be the boys, in their 12 to 13, 200 meter dash. Breeze is beginning to pick back up a little bit.
And the athletes are down. Oh, they're told to stand up again.
Okay, they're on the start.
They're off. Good start from the athlete from Winnington in lane six.
Off the curve is first, here's Ona Glinton, but she's now being challenged on the inside by Holy Family.
Here comes Ona Glinton again.
Ona Glinton is making another charge. Holy Family is still holding form.
Here comes Ona Glinton. It's going to be Ona Glinton and Holy
Family.
Andy
Pratt is giving it, but Ona Glinton is going to take this one. Miss Williams for Ona Glinton coming in first place, followed by Holy Family. Then coming in was INT Pratt. That's how they're going to end that one. What a good race, what a good run from Williams. Ran the curve really hard, and that took her into the straight. And also, you know, even though Holy Family was giving chase, she was able to hold her off at the end and power through the line. That's going to be very interesting to see that final with these girls. It's going to be very, very, very interesting. As you see, guys, on the replay, she was able to power her way, even though the athlete from Holy Family was giving chase. But she was able to power through the line. So congrats to her on her winning her heat. Now, we're going to move to the boys, 12 to 13, 200-meter dash. We're going to wait for them to marshal out. But as of right now, we still have the jumps going on, guys, right in front of us. Have another pass of rain, might be. In this event, especially the long jump, and I'm watching the coaches, you know, this is the first I've seen a coach talk up their athlete and explaining to them what they need to do in this particular event. And then normally that's the rule of thumb. Coaches can talk to their athlete and get them to understand, hey, this is what I need you to do, and, you know, that sort of thing. And it's the first I've seen it. So.
Right. Not very good big steps going forward, for sure.
All right, guys, we have another trivia for you. What year did Team TCI win the first medal in a relay event? You have 2012, 2004, 2011, or 2016?
Let's see the results here.
Okay, guys, on the screen, as you can see, what year did TCI win the first medal in a relay event? 2012, 2004, 2011, 2016. See anything interesting so far, Mr. Garland?
No, I think this is just the Ona Glinton people. Say 2004. No, 2012. Yes, Miss Keisha Chase.
Miss Keisha Chase. Yes.
That is correct. 2012.
2012.
2012. That was the year we won in Bermuda.
Listen. I was waiting to see if she was going to say. Right now, you're sitting right now, like, yes, okay, yeah, let's wait and see.
That was in Bermuda. The team of Ifani, to Delano, to myself, to Cheyenne Parker.
Yes.
In Bermuda, we got third.
I was waiting. I was like, wait. And the man is sitting right next to me. So let's wait and see what they say, because he's sitting right next to me.
Good job, Miss Keisha. Good job.
Good job. Good job, Miss Chase. Not too far behind also was Miss Melly walking.
Right.
She was right there with it as well, too. So shout out to you guys. But I think you guys also improved on that 4x1. But was it the 4x200 you guys did in the Bahamas?
Yeah, the 4x1 record was broken a couple times after that. It was 2012, then I think they had a team that broke it like in 2014. But I know recently we broke it 2022 at the Commonwealth Games.
Yes, I remember this. I was saying to you now, I know you guys improved on that as well, too.
So.
But like I said, again, records are made to be broken.
Oh, yeah, most definitely.
I'm.
Most definitely.
Yeah. As you can see in front of us, guys, the girls are there for the long jump pit. It's the girls under 11 long jump. Like I said again, we have both sides of the field being utilized for this long jump. And this is the girls' flight 1 and 2. This is the girls under 11, ages 10 to 11. That should be, it should be very interesting. I mean, taking us into the start of our boys' 200 meters, so we're now awaiting that to kick off. Okay, the race is about to start.
And they are down. And they're off. Oh, good start from the athlete. From
that athlete in lane six. That is out of athlete Amla. He is blazing. But in the middle of the field, here comes the athlete from INT Pratt. And he's putting on a great run, but the athlete from Adelaide Amla is able to hold him off. Enid Capron is making a good charge. It's Iris Stubbs. It's going to take that one home. Iris Stubbs. It's going to take that one home. That was a beautiful run. I mean, coming off the car for a bit, I wasn't sure as to where he would end up. But he was able to power down the track in the straightaway to take himself into first position. Good run. Because I see that Jolly was right up on him, almost had him at the line, but it was a good run to run through. All right, guys, on the track now is going to be heat 204 for the boys 12 to 13, 200-meter dash. In lane two, we have Evan Gardner. From the Charles Hubert James, bid number 94. In lane three, we have Justin Coville, bid number 224, Adelaide Amla. In lane four, we have Caden Davis, bid number 408, Asita Jolly. In lane five, we have Makai Forbes, bid number 125, from Doris Robinson. And in lane six, we have Jordan Ali Steve, bid number 291, INT Pratt. And in lane seven, we have Arobi Seymour, bid number 333 from Irish Stubbs. This should be another good race as well. The upper class boys are here to show out. All right, guys, I also want to give a shout out while I have the opportunity to Project IGM Media Club for them being out here and being on our cameras and giving you guys the images that you're seeing, the footage, the angles, everything you see today. We want to give a shout out to Project Idea Media Club for doing their thing, man. Yes, this is a sports commission program. So all you young folks out there interested in broadcasting and media, this is something you should definitely check out. And just so you know, guys, again, all our cameramen, it's from this program. So all the angles you're seeing, they're down on the track.
We're down. And they're off. Good start from the athlete in lane six. Also a good run from the athlete in lane seven. They'll be the two off the curve.
Off the curve as Iris stops.
Oh, the athlete in seven,
yes,
made a push.
Giving chase is INT Pratt, and that's the way it's going to end. I think Iris Stubbs has completely pulled away from the rest of the field. Adelaide Amla is in third position, holding from, but also the athlete from Doris Robinson is giving chase, but it's going to end that way where we have Iris Stubbs, INT Pratt, and Adelaide Amla taking first, second, and third. All right, guys, next on the track is heat 3 or 4. And we have in lane 2, Makai Wilson, bet number 386 from Ona Glinton. In lane 3, we have Vashon Francois, bet number 447, Provo Christian. In lane 4, Nathaniel Mizik, bet number 525, Richmond Hill. In lane number 5, we have Dorian Joseph, bet number 574, Wesley Methodist. And in lane 6, Rowan Paul, bet number 185, Elite School. And we have in lane 7, Xavier Carey, bet number 113 from Community Christian. And this is boys under 13, ages 12 to 13. This is heat number 3, 200 meter dash, heat number 3. There you go, guys, as you see them on the track. Based on what we've seen, these lanes don't matter because these guys are still running at their best off these lanes.
Competitive system. Heat 3 or 4 coming up.
You would think that this would have bothered them in a sense, but right. I'm lanes don't matter to these guys. They just want to get out and run. That's just pretty much it. And this is, like I said again, guys, this is heat 3 or 4. Boys 12 to 13, 200 meter dash. All right, guys. We have a white flag at the start, and the race is off. Out in front, the athlete from Community Christian has a huge lead on the field. Coming off the bend first, he's going to be the first into the straightaway. Now, pulling Eva, making up the stagger. Here comes the athlete from Una Glinton, Mr. Wilson, out in lane 1, followed by the athlete from Provo Christian, Vashon Francois. They're giving chase, but I think Provo Christian is going to hold on. Mr. Wilson is going to come in for Una Glinton at second, and we're going to have Vashon Francois from Provo Christian coming in third. There you have it, guys. Out in lane 7, Xavier Carey, Community Christian, taking first place. Makai Wilson from Una Glinton taking second, followed by Vashon Francois from Provo Christian School taking third place. Out in front, that young man seems to be out in front by himself, cruising, just relaxing through the line. Then we see Mr. Wilson coming in. Also, Francois. I think this final, it's going to be really, depending on the lane assignment, that final is going to be really, really crazy. Because out of lane 7, Carey was out of the blocks, onto the straightaway, faster than anybody coming off the curve. But Mr. Wilson made his mark in the middle of the curve, propelling him into the straight and trying to give chase. Beautiful run by all the athletes. As you can see right here, he was a little too far ahead. Carey went out too hard, and I guess nobody followed, and that was able to carry him through the line. All right, guys, this is going to be heat 4 of 4, boys 12 to 13, 200-meter dash. In lane 2, we have Jeff Galen, bet number 115, Community Christian. In lane 3, Tyquan Williams, bet number 385, Ona Glinton. In lane number 4, Grayson Etienne, bet number 234, Enid Capron. In lane 5, we have Jamari Heath, bet number 520, Richmond Hill. In lane number 6, Aaron Hall, bet number 96, Charles Hubert James. And lane number 7, we have Kovora Adino, bet number 565, Thelma Lightburn. This is heat 4-4, boys 12 to 13, 200 meter dash on the track, guys. Just waiting on the start. But like I said again, man, the day is going by perfectly in terms of getting out. Even though we had a rain, you know, a little bit of rain this morning, but it's not stopping anything. Our athletes are moving at a quick pace and getting through these runs first thing this morning. I know we have long jump going on with the girls. It's going to be followed by the boys' long jump, and we should get this thing moving on the track in the start position. Heat 4-4. Richmond Hill is coming off the curve really, really, really strong. He's powering out to a good lead. Onto the straightaway. He's been chased by the athlete from Una Glinton, giving chase. It's going to be a good finish. Richmond Hill is going to be able to hold him off. But the athlete from Una Glinton, Mr. Williams, gave a beautiful run. But Richmond Hills is going to take it, followed by Enid Capron. Yes, Richmond Hill. Unofficial, 27-71, unofficial. Unofficial. There you have it, folks, on your screen. Richmond Hill powering in, followed by Mr. Williams from Una Glinton. And we have Etienne from Enid Capron coming in third position, unofficial, guys. My thing is, I think had Mr. Williams made his attack a little earlier, it might have been a closer race. I think he allowed the athlete from Richmond Hill to get a little too ahead of him to not be able to carry him through. Adina powered down off to the straight first, then Williams made his attack. I think had he made it earlier, they would have been neck and neck at the finish line. But nonetheless, what a great run by Williams and also Adina. All right, guys, we have another question up on the screen for you guys. What was the highest medal count Team TCI has won at a single career of the game? Is it 5? Is it 6? Is it 3? Is it 7? Once again, what is the highest medal count Team TCI has won at a single career of the game? All right, guys, there you have it again on our screen. If you are paying attention, this is where we are with our trivia question on the screen. There you guys see it on the screen. What is the total count of medals TCI has ever won in a single career, though? Like I say, guys, you guys have now watched the conclusion of all of our 200 meters events. Let's see now what happens in the finals. And you guys had the opportunity to, you know, tune in live to watch our morning session. Yes, still in the morning session, got off to a little late start. But again, I want to give a shout out to all the athletes that's participating here. All 500 of them. Go ahead, what, did we have an answer? Who was the answer?
It's Williams. Answer is 3, which is correct.
Yes, the answer is 3, folks.
We actually did it twice. It was 2011. We had 3 medals. And then last year, we also had 3 medals. Last year was Mr. Walking.
Yes, Love Joseph.
Love Joseph. In 2011, it was Delano Williams, Andy Clark.
Yes. And well, also, Travis Henfield also got 3 as well. Then you would have Blair Williams. So,
right.
Travis Henry, Blair Williams, Timadia Williams, you guys are correct.
Right.
And like I said again, it would have been duplicated several times.
Right.
So
you can't really count the relay medals because it's still counted.
Single, yes.
Right.
Still a single medal.
Still a single medal.
But I mean, at the end of the day, that seems to be our mark. But at one day we come back with a haul. We're gonna come back with a haul of medals. You watch
it.
I mean, think about it. Rayvon Black is doing his thing right now.
Right.
We know what Love Joseph has done. He's shown us what he can do.
Right.
The ceiling for Rayvon, I think, hasn't been there yet. He's still in that you know, growing process. And we know for sure our other athletes are going to definitely come through and do their thing.
Oh, yeah, for sure, for sure. To win a semifinal at the Boys and Girls Championship is a big thing.
Oh, man.
And I think what Rayvon did this morning was remarkable. So I think he has a good chance to go big when the time comes.
Listen, this is so funny. The answer to the question, someone said Ona Glinton.
I mean, that is my alma mater, so I can't.
Listen, of course. But you see, again, sitting up here, you know, I have to be completely
right.
Neutral. We ain't going to say anything, but yes, shout outs to all the teams here
right,
at
sure.
the Interprimary Championships. Anyways, guys, I want to give a shout out to a lot of you guys out there. If you guys are interested in giving back to your community, interested in you know, being a mentor or, you know, helping our younger athletes, you know, I'm proud to be a part of a great club there in Grand Turk. Also have a club here in Providenciales. I wear it proudly on my chest, the Rotary Club of Grand Turk. I want to give a shout out to you guys again. If you guys are looking for, you know, camaraderie, giving back to the community, you know, being a part of something that matters, please do check us out there in Grand Turk, man. You guys won't be disappointed. We love to have you to be able to grow and become better.
I think it'll be this one, though. Will you be sharing that?
Yeah. All right, guys, we're still here at the National Stadium. Right now, there might be, they're setting up now for some relays. So we're going to have some heat going on a little later once we get back from a little break. But I think right now, joining me right now, you guys, she's no stranger to you guys. You guys know exactly who she is. So what have you seen today? What have caught your eye today?
Hey, good morning, Turks and Caicos. Donovan, those of you who are watching us live, I saw some exciting races today. I came in a little late, so I missed some of the prelims that they had, but I just watched the 200 meters that was ran.
I got a question for you. You know, today you come out here looking like, ba-bam, what's going on?
You know, we ladies, we got to make ourselves look good. So I had to do a thing.
I got you. Yeah, and you did a thing. You definitely did a thing.
Yeah. Yesterday I was... kind of.
Yeah, listen,
so right. I said, no, I got to do a thing if I'm going to come online.
There we go. Yeah, but as you were saying, in terms of the action.
Yeah, some of the action that I saw, I mean, some of these young athletes, especially the 200 meters that I just saw ran there by these athletes, they're running really well. Some of the times I've seen, they're really doing some good work out here with these athletes. Those PE teachers that are training, PE teachers, they're not coaches, they're PE teachers. They're doing an excellent job. Kudos to them. And I must shout out Ms. Dunn. I talked about it when I was on the radio just now. I must shout out to Ms. Dunn and her crew up there at Ona Glinton. These athletes are well prepared down here for this meet here. They're the defending champs, and they come ready. They come down here and they're ready. So I must say kudos to all the primary school PE teachers that has these athletes out here today.
I mean, if you do think about it, in my opinion, you know, being able to win this event 2 years back-to-back and not necessarily have this in Grand Turk speaks volumes into her program, to all the help that she gets in relation to preparing these kids for such an event. But not even that. Sharon, we got 21 schools here, Sharon, and I think every athlete that performs here, it shows the preparation that the coach puts into to their program and getting them ready. So, you know, seeing a kid run 27.71, I think that was the best we saw in the 200 meters for the boys, 12 to 13. That was probably one of the best times we've seen. So that goes to show you what's happening in these schools.
Yes.
And again, you said the word PE teacher, not coach. Yeah. And that shows that, you know, they can take clay and mold it into what we're seeing here now on the track.
Yeah, I totally agree with you there. And also, I must mention, we talk about the Grand Tuck schools a lot because we actually watch the young athletes from Grand Tuck. I mean, there's nothing against the schools down Provo.
No.
We don't see them that much, so that's why we talk a lot about what we see of the athletes in Grand Tuck.
Well, but that's the thing that I was saying to Angelo. We can call an athlete name easily because they're from Grand Tuck or, you know, Eli Simons, let's say for instance, we know that. But coming here now, you have to really understand or look at the paper to see who's who.
Yes.
So I don't want nobody to feel as if, oh, we just know. That's easier for us to do. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, I can think all these kids are, like I say, Sharon, to me, I'm ready to see the little 5 to 7 year old again. I don't know about you, but I'm dying to see them again, Sharon.
Me too. I'm waiting to see them run also again too, because they're the most exciting ones that you come out here and watch. These what the young athletes that they're just coming out and they're eager to perform and they're running, just running and running and running. Those are the races that we want to see too.
Man. Those and what is so crazy about that, Sharon? You would think they would stop at the finish. No, they just want to keep running. They don't even care. So like you say, they can scratch back and do an 80 if you're going to keep running off the curve. So giving them a 60 meters is not necessarily doing them justice. They can go a little faster or a little further than that, I should say.
Yes, and I was watching like the jumps, even the jumps. I mean, you have the tiny little, the tiny tots out here jumping. They're barely getting in the pit, but at least the effort is there.
Yeah, they're showing you
so
that they're ready
that
to do that.
Yes, they want to do it and throwing the ball. Some of them, they're only must be 3 feet, and they're out there throwing the softball as hard as they can,
well, you know,
and as far as they can.
One of the craziest things Angelo said, he's used to training junior and senior athletes, but he takes his hat off to all the coaches who deal with the younger kids and at this age level and getting them committed and understanding what it is that they need them to do or wanting them to do. So, you know, having that aspect of it. I mean, him saying that and being a coach himself, that tells you how hard or difficult that is to train our up-and-coming grassroots athletes.
Yes, and we talked about it yesterday and continue to talk about it and give praise to the Sports Commission, the TC3As, all the volunteers for this meet here because 575 athletes, I mean, young athletes, they're well-disciplined, the athletes. They're in the back by their tents. They're not running around. They're well-behaved. The meet is well put together. All the volunteers and those that are out here, the officials that are out here helping out, giving a helping hand to keep this meet under control.
Yes, definitely.
And present it to the public. It's kudos to them.
The wind seems to be picking up a bit now, Sharon. And hopefully, going into this afternoon, the finals, we don't have an issue to where the wind hinders some of our athletes. Because I'm looking for that 27.71. I'm looking for something. I mean, faster than that. I promise you.
Yeah, I don't know. This weather down here, Donovan, is just changing. I mean, yesterday it was extremely hot. I mean, it's really bipolar, but it was extremely hot yesterday and this morning. We got up, it's pouring rain.
Yeah.
I mean, it's pouring down rain. It's cooler now. At least it's cooler than what it was yesterday because that heat out there was draining for the athletes, for those young athletes. I pitied them because it was hot for me and I was just sitting down.
And the crazy thing is, I mean, Angelo was talking about it. You know, us older folks, we deal with things like lactate acid and all this other stuff. These kids ain't getting tired.
No.
I watched them go from the board jump to the 150 meters, back to the ball jump again, and you saw no let down or no let off in terms of what they were doing. So that goes to show you that, you know, they're conditioned, they're young, they're energetic. So, you know, by all means, they're just having fun, and I love that for them to be able to have this opportunity to showcase their talent, their skills out on such a grand stage for us to see and witness. I mean, like I say, we spoke about it yesterday. You heard them talking about Rayvon Black in terms of this was the sport that, or this event at the primary school where he was picked.
He's coming out.
Look at it now. He is now qualified for the finals at Boys Champs. Tomorrow night, he won his semi. You know, so going in, he's going in with the second fastest time. So shout outs to his mother. Shout outs to Rayvon Black for doing your thing. Shout outs to his school, Ona Clinton. So you guys should be proud of what he's doing, Turks and Caicos. We need to be proud of that young man. And going to boys' champs and really dominating reminds me of when Delano was at the at that school in terms of, you know, so it's kind of like the same situation happening all over again. So I'm happy for him to be able to have that particular opportunity.
And Rayvon's story, Donovan, is really a testimony of picking grassroots talent. Because he was a young boy. You remember he got in that accident.
Yes, ma'am.
A serious accident. In
and Grand. To come back from
and
that.
And he got in an accident. He was on the basketball court. So he was playing basketball. And he ran across the road and got knocked down. And he got in an accident, unfortunately. But he came back. And he came back as a strong athlete. And he was picked. And his talent was shown at the primary school championship, where nobody knew we even had it.
Yep.
You understand? So, and his story is almost like Delano's story, because Delano was found playing softball.
Ah.
And yes, and it came around the same time when it was Ike, Hurricane Ike. And the coach saw him running after a softball. And then that was when Grand Tuck was hit hard by Ike. And he decided to take him to Jamaica to go to school. And the same thing with Rayvon Black. When he got in the accident and he came back, and he came back on his feet and he came down here, then he decides to go to Jamaica. And and now he's doing extremely well in Jamaica. And like you say, when we come down to these championships where you can see the raw talent, and then you get the opportunity to go to a place like Jamaica where you can train and compete against your competitor, because Jamaica is one of our competitors. Exactly. And once you get down there and you're competing with them, and I always go back to the Cox brothers. When they were in school in Jamaica, they were beating the Jamaicans when they were there. So this is what we see when we come down to these championships. You can see this raw talent that we have, and once they go up and train, they get better. These are the results that we get.
Definitely. Sharon, with that being said, we're now going to take a break. They're now going to go into the lunch hour, and we guys will resume shortly. Please do stay tuned. You've now been listening to Day 2 morning session of the 2024 Interprimary Championships. All right, guys, we'll be back for the evening session.
Hello everyone, it's Delano Williams here, your Olympian. You know what's coming, it's the Inter-Primary School Track and Field Championships taking place March 19th through to the 21st, right here at the National Stadium.
I have Coach Tyler here. We have created our own champs because we are so excited to celebrate with you guys.
I'm battling Coach Delano to take my crown as the new Sports Day champion.
Now there are three parts to this race. You have the potato sack race, the egg and spoon, and my favorite, the 40 meter dash.
Are you ready?
Let's get moving.
Hey!
Tyler, put us on the line. I hope you put that there. Tyler is cheating. Liza Simons Primary. That's the school I went to. Are we ready?
Go!
Tyler, false start, man.
He twitched. You got it.
Okay, I give him that. I false started because I twitched.
She holding it for long.
Man, that's a long hold, man, Andina. God. He's running. He's running.
I got one.
I got one.
I'm going to win the next one.
But guess what?